Hi, Simon Ridgway here from Rackla, and we're in the camp in the Northwest Territories, and I'm sitting here with Scott Casselman, who's the VPX of the company, and Quinton Hennigh, who's here to give us some advice on where we should drill. So guys, welcome to the camp. Sorry it's raining, but that's all it does here apparently.
I've been getting used to it, Simon. I've been here from the get-go, and yeah, we got to roll with the punches.
So you guys acquired the project just last year. You're drilling really.
We staked it in July of last year.
That's incredible. So yeah, you set the land speed record for picking up a property and going to drill stage.
Yeah.
So Scott, what helped you define this as a drill target so soon?
So as Simon mentioned, over the 3 years, we've been evaluating a number of targets. I think we had 12 different Cretaceous intrusions that we looked at. And we saw indications in pretty well all of them of a potential for a reduced intrusion-related gold system. But what we saw when we got to the particular target we're working on now at Grad was just an order of magnitude better than anything else that we'd seen. All of the features that you look for in this type of deposit were there, and were there quite spectacularly. So Cretaceous intrusion, number one. Good density of sheeted veining that was obvious on surface. Lots of gossanous staining from the sulfide minerals in those veins that was staining the cliff face. Our geochemistry, when it came back, we had gold, but we also had the key indicators of tellurium and bismuth. From that, we named our key showing, the bite showing, BI for bismuth, TE for tellurium. And the other thing that made it interesting is there's really good exposure on the Grad property. So we had all of the geology staring us right in the face. And to that, exploration season in the north here is quite short. So if we wanted to get drilling this year, we knew we had to jump on it early. And that would allow us to get some early drill results and then design our program beyond that with those results. So those factors all came together to bring this program together.
I mean, it is astounding to go from acquiring a property through staking all the way to drilling so quickly. But I agree that this type of system is conducive for doing that. I'm not going to say anything's a no-brainer in life, but you know, in terms of geology, these types of gold systems are kind of in that league where you can walk up and drill test after collecting a bit of surface data that suggests you got a big system here. Now, one of the things I've learned over the past couple of days being out here is that the topography is relatively steep. You know, we're dealing with some pretty rugged terrain here.
Absolutely.
And I think you have to be very selective about where you put drill holes and how you approach this. I think it's important too that people understand that you guys have identified the different types of veins and their orientation, and you're trying to drill at an optimal angle across those. So dealing with the steep terrain and then, you know, the need to focus the drill in the right direction, you have a very specific way you have to drill this thing. I think it's a fair way to put it, right?
And there's a lot, it's very dangerous. I mean, the cliff is mobile, right? Yeah, so we really got to pick those drill pads well.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of trade-off between the safety factor and what you ideally would like to do as a geologist is hit these veins perpendicular.
Yeah.
But Mother Nature puts a few twists in there. For the most part, that we could drill anywhere on that cliff face. It's been done in many other circumstances, but we're trying to take the cautious approach for now. Okay. But eventually we're going to put the big, huge hole right through the hole of that mountain.
One of the things that, you know, getting to site here and looking at the core, both from the first hole and now the one that you just completed, look, this doesn't have the exact same characteristics as some other systems like Snowline, like Valley, where you see discrete quartz veins with little blebs of bismuth minerals and often a little speck or two of gold here and there, okay? And that's kind of a characteristic here. I've seen multiple different types of veins in the core I've seen over the past couple of days. And what really stands out to me is that there's a lot of bismuth minerals. Like there are some veins here where it's very abundant.
Yeah.
In my view, it's like I've described it as different flavors of the same type of ice cream. It's, you know, we're dealing with chocolate ice cream, a reduced intrusive system, sure. But, you know, some is Rocky Road, some is, you know, mocha flavor.
Right.
You know, it's like we're just dealing with a bit different flavor. Yeah. And I'm seeing a lot more bismuth in these veins.
Yeah.
And to me, I think maybe an explanation for why you don't see the visible gold, even in rock that you've sampled and has high grade, is because the gold's actually being hidden by the bismuth itself.
Yeah.
Okay. Is that a possibility?
Absolutely. I like that analogy and the description that you gave to us. We do see very high bismuth values across the full extent with good gold. But we haven't yet seen that visible gold that other players in the region have. So we know the gold's in there, and I guess it's just not going to be visible in our case.
I remember you brought a rock, and I can't remember, sometime over the winter, but after you put the news release out about this discovery last year in, say, October or whenever it was,
right?
You had a rock you showed me. You said, hey, this grade's 90 grams per ton or something like that. And I remember pulling my handlings out and looking at this thing, and I'm thinking, I can't see any gold.
Yeah.
And I could see little specks of bismuth minerals, but I couldn't see any gold. Is it a reduced intrusion? Absolutely. There's no question this is the right kind of system. But I think it's important for people to understand it because, you know, at Snowline and some of these other stories, like I think Sitka now recently, they denote seeing visible gold and core, and that's an easy one to put in front of the public and understand. Here we're dealing with bismuth, and a lot of people are scratching their head. Oh, what are these guys talking about? You know, this, to me, looking at the veins and how many of them have actual bismuth minerals, I think that's the key here. Like, you got to, it's a little bit different playing field. You got to look at it differently. I think the gold's going to be there. I think, you know, we got to see when the assays come back. But but in my view, the bismuth itself is the proxy for for gold.
Yeah. And all of the limited amount of analytical work that we've done so far is showing that there is a good correlation with bismuth, good correlation with tellurium, and we're getting good gold values.
Earlier today, you showed me your drill plan, like conceptually how you plan to do this, and you showed me that you've identified a place where you can put a pad up, elevation wise, up a bit, and on the west side so that you can actually drill some longer holes.
Right.
Can you talk a little bit about, like, what can you see doing by the end of this season?
At the base of the slope where all of our historic work was done, the work we did last year, we planned on 2,000 meters there, shorter holes, testing it, getting a proof of concept. Before we got aggressive and moved up the hill. The vertical extent of the cliff above that zone is 350 meters. So our big hole that we're planning would be roughly halfway up that cliff, and it would go through basically the whole of the mountain. So it would be approximately 150 meters above where we're drilling now. And from where we're drilling now, we're going down deeper. Okay. So this hole would go through that hole 150 meters above, and then as well continue on paralleling those holes that we're drilling now, but looking at a horizontal step of approximately 200 meters, I believe.
So, okay, I'm going to follow up on something you said a little bit earlier, is that in the bottoms of these holes, the geologists who are logging these have seen an increasing intensity of veining and stuff. And I've seen them now, and I can tell you that is absolutely the case, okay? As you're going down, there's even a significant amount of alteration, like, you know, visible discoloration of the rock, and more fluids have definitely passed through these. It looks like you're getting more and more into something. So it's quite comforting to hear that you're saying that the later drill holes that are going to be up higher, they're going to be long enough to get down a bit deeper into the system.
Yeah.
My hunch, my queasy gizzard here, is that you are in a very, you're in the Goldilocks zone of a reduced intrusive system.
Yeah.
You basically have an intrusion here, which is a nice size, like sometimes these big ones, they're eroded away, but you're basically seeing a window of erosion that's taking you down into the top, like the roof of this intrusion. So that means it's well preserved, and if so, then your gold system is probably also well preserved, which means you have a lot of runway below you. If I had one takeaway, I'd say I've concluded this is a very big system. It's certainly got all the right juices and flavor. Okay, I think the exploration strategy you have this year to kind of take a few nibbles at it and try to figure out where the center of gravity is and then come back and late in the season and drill some deeper holes, I like that a lot. I think what I would want people to understand, like in the investment world, is this is a new discovery. And what your goal this year is to show that you have something that has big scale. I think you can get there with what you have. It doesn't mean by the end of the season you're going to have a resource.
No.
This is the first year, okay? But
that's right.
If you walk out of here with some big long intercepts,
continuity,
you've hit a home run.
Thanks for your time.
Thanks,
coming up.
You.
It's been great to spend a bit of time with you again.
It's been a lot of fun.
Hopefully we can get you out of here tonight. Not because we don't like you being here. Just
get that guy out of here.
It's time for you to get home, right?
Okay.